In this segment, we'll continue with the example which we have. We have Gaussian elimination. What we're trying to do is we are developing algorithms called Gaussian elimination with partial pivoting to solve simultaneous linear equations. And we're taking an example here, and we'll look at the back substitution part of that example. So at the end of the forward elimination steps, we got the equation in the matrix form, where for the set of equations to be as follows. We got 144, 12, 1, ace of 1, ace of 2, ace of 3. And we got, this is an upper triangular matrix. Right hand side is 279.2, 58.33, and minus 0.23. So this is what we obtain at the end of the forward elimination steps, and you can see that it is in that form where the coefficient matrix is an upper triangular matrix. Everything below the diagonal is zero. So in the back substitution, the reason why I call it back substitution, because we're going backwards. We're going to start from the last equation, find ace of 3, then go to the second last equation, find ace of 2, go to the third last equation, which in this case is the first equation, and find ace of 1. Because in this last equation, ace of 3 is the only unknown. In the second equation, there are two unknowns, ace of 2 and ace of 3, but ace of 3 we just found out. So we have only one unknown, which is ace of 2. In the first equation, or the third last equation, we have three unknowns, ace of 1, ace of 2, ace of 3, but we just found ace of 2 and ace of 3, so ace of 1 can be found from the first equation or third last equation. So let's go and go through this process of back substitution. So what I'll get ace of 3, I'll get minus 0.2 ace of 3, that's the last equation, is equal to minus 0.23, and ace of 3 is minus 0.23 divided by minus 0.2, which is 1.15. So that's the value which I get for ace of 3. Now let's calculate ace of 2, which will be from the second equation here. So let's see what I get for ace of 2. I get 2.917 ace of 2 plus 0.8264 ace of 3 is equal to 58.33. And so ace of 2 will be equal to 58.33 minus, we'll take this to the right hand side because we know ace of 3. And then I'm going to divide by this 2.917. So I get 58.33 minus 0.8264. Ace of 3 is 1.15. I divide it by 2.917. So that's what I'm doing, and I'm getting 19.67. Again, keep in mind, as mentioned before, I'm using only four significant digits in showing the calculations. If you use more, you wouldn't get slightly different answer from than what I have. I'm only doing this for the purpose of keeping things simple. Now, let's look at the last equation. We have 144 ace of 1 plus 12 ace of 2 plus ace of 3 is equal to 279.2. So we've got to find ace of 1 from here. So again, ace of 1 will be 279.2. I'm going to take 12 ace of 2 to the right-hand side because ace of 2 is known, minus ace of 3 because ace of 3 is known, divided by 144. So that gives me 279.2 minus 12 times ace of 2. Ace of 2 we just found is 19.67. Ace of 3 we found out previously is 1.15, divided by 144. And this value here turns out to be 0.2917. So we have all the values which we need to find, ace of 1, ace of 2, and ace of 3. So let me go ahead and write down these values. So the resulting unknown vector which we had, or the solution vector which we had, ace of 1, ace of 2, ace of 3, has been just found by using the back substitution algorithm. Ace of 1 turning out to be 0.2917, ace of 2 turning out to be 19.67, and 1.15. So that is the solution there. So as homework, what I'm going to do, I've been harping about this throughout this segment and previous segment, that I'm only showing you only four significant digits in my calculations. I'm not using only four significant digits, but I'm only showing you four significant digits in your calculations. So what I would like you to do is to redo the problem showing five significant digits. I'm not talking about that you need to do individual calculations using five significant digits with chopping or rounding, but as you are showing the final results, intermediate results, that you're going to use only five significant digits. So redo the problem showing five significant digits and see whether you get a slightly different answer, which you should. That is the end of this segment.